So what is that? So can I please help me to know you, what you do at FirstBank?
Okay, my name is Folashade-Femi. I'm the segment head for Pubilc Sector and Telecom in Mobile Financial Services in FirstBank.
All right. So what do, in layman terms, on the street, what does that mean for layman on the street?
Okay. For the layman on the street, what it means is that FirstBank is bringing financial services, banking services to them at their doorstep. Mm. They don't need to come to the four walls of the bank. Mm. They don't need to come to the brick and mortar. Mm. They just have financial business, financial service, financial transactions, doing banking from the comfort of their homes, on their phones.
And especially on their phones.
Yes.
Interesting. Now, there has been a lot of noise about mobile money in Nigeria. And I must confess to you, from inception till now, we haven't scratched up to half of the potential that we have in Nigeria. What is the problem with mobile money in Nigeria?
No, there's actually no problem with mobile money in Nigeria. If you recall the advent of mobile telecommunications, like I was asking MBTs at the call, that some of us had to buy a 5,000 phone that is bundled with a SIM, just for you to be able to make a dial and then you can hear your loved one's voice on the other hand. But today, 12 years, 13 years after, it's now very almost free. A SIM card is as good as free.
Yeah.
And then you can have 2,000, 1,500 like I was making phone that would Tigra phone, China made phone can use mobile money. Mm-hmm. Now, why you think there's a problem, which I can tell you as a player, I have been in telecommunication business since inception, since 2001, when Equinix made the first call. Mm-hmm. Now, I'm one of the pioneers. So, and I can tell you that it took a while. People were used to Nitel, people were used to the long distance, doing regularly going to the cyber cafe to make a call. Mm-hmm. You know, those calls that you have to make, and then you can only hear, you have to keep quiet for the other person to talk.
Well.
Then over time, and then because of the cost of entry that had been prohibited, it took it a while. But by the time the masses got to understand, okay, this is for real, you will expect the slowness to adoption. Mm. People are not sure. Like I said,
trust.
The three elements, trust has got to be there. And so we're getting there. And that's why I said FirstBank is different, because FirstBank is going to, for my own segment, Pubilc Sector, we're partnering with government. Mm. Lately, as of last Friday, we signed a partnership with UNICEF to support them in eradicating polio across Nigeria.
Right.
And so we're going to be disbursing money to the volunteer community mobilizers.
Mm.
Instead of them to be struggling, the woman wants to travel several kilometers to get to the nearest now to collect just a little money they hand for mobilizing people to take immunization. Now we're sending it to them on their phones.
Mm.
And they can go to the nearest again to get the cash or do some other things with them.
Mm.
So we're getting there slowly but surely.
Okay, interesting. While we're talking, I listen so closely. And you mentioned about the Kenyan model.
Yes.
This is the M-Pesa.
Yes.
Now, in Kenya, the telecom drove mobile money through Safari.
That's right.
In South Africa, it is the banks that drove the mobile money.
Correct.
Now, in Nigeria, there seems to be a friction of the two. What are your thoughts on this?
Now, my thoughts on that is that Central Bank of Nigeria has done well in saying it has to be bank-driven, it has to be bank-led. Now, I thought that what I was saying at the presentation is that the terrain, the Nigerian terrain is different from Kenya terrain. And that's why people no longer send money home in Nigeria. The people at home, they are here with us in Lagos, so there's nobody to send money home to. However, the terrain is also different. Now, the mobile money operators, they are not insured to carry cash. So you recognize that the central bank governor is doing a whole lot to put Nigeria on the global map. And so in line with that, cashless policy can only be driven by a financial institution that has been properly licensed. So I will pitch my thanks with him, not because I'm particularly working in a particular bank, but because as an industry player, that's the right thing to do. And the best that could even happen is for them. Telecom partners to partner with us as a strategy partner for both parties to make a difference, and I think we are coming to that now.
Excellent.
We are.
Excellent. I like that part. Now, in terms of mobile money to gain adoption, and you mentioned a keyword called trust of Nigeria. So, how is FirstBank helping to educate Nigerians? Because that's one of the things we hold core in our media company. We educate people on the pros and the challenges of mobile. So as a corporate entity, what are you doing as a corporate organization to be able to encourage and educate a lot of people, especially those in the rural areas who just have internet on their phone? You get a lot of hits from people on their phone. So what is FirstBank doing in to be able to educate?
Now, as a corporate social responsible organization, FirstBank is number one brand, number one retail bank in Nigeria. We are at the forefront of such opportunities. And I can tell you one of them is this platform. If we are not a co-sponsor of this project, program, you will see us here. So we have seen it as an opportunity, because if you can educate a woman, you have educated a whole nation. And so that's part of our initiative. And we are also partnering with UNICEF. Part of the corporate social responsibility in our partnership with UNICEF is for us to join them, support them in organizing radio jingles across the nation in different languages, teaching them on the possibilities, the endless possibilities that you can do with your phone. And so we recognize that it is this continuous engagement into education, mass education of the masses, education of the high and low. Because the rural poor will not go to send money to me in town. I am the one that will send money to my grandmother in the village. And so you need to get me educated. When I start sending money to grandma and telling grandma, okay, grandma, the money is on your phone, so go to the nearest bank. The grandma will start telling her friend that, my granddaughter has sent money to me on the phone. So I believe we're on track. And we're also part of so many programs that are ready, that are useful for the masses. First market.
All right. I'm going to give you one blank check right now. And I'm going to ask you a question. Now, FirstBank is a major player in mobile money. And as such, every company out there, they have their offerings given to people. So what will be the unique differentiating factor for FirstBank? Because they have other banks that preach mobile money to them. So why should they adopt FirstBank? Because I see your tweets every time on that.
I was going to come to that. We also do. We are on the digital media.
Okay.
We are on the. I mean, all that you have mentioned, you find us there. You find, and then in the next couple of weeks, watch out. We are breaking out on media campaign. You know, but what makes FirstBank different? I will tell you. We have the name. We have the trust. Few banks, if that's the only bank that has been around for more than 100 years. Now, if you go to any village, so to speak, your grandmother and your grandfather will tell you, oh, I have an account with FirstBank. Now, that's, and then we have enjoyed the goodwill of the Nigerian people, because we have gone through several successions in the boardroom without anybody fight about that. So we have that behind. We're number one retail bank in Nigeria, and we have the trust. People know that when you keep your money in FirstBank, it is safe. We have now governance issues. Those are basic things that drive trust, that I mentioned. And when that is there, you know that your money is safe. And not just that, our value proposition to the Nigerian people is a whole lot. We are breaking out in a lot of campaigns in the next couple of weeks. And so I won't just talk about that for confidentiality reasons. But I can tell you, we have the plan for the Nigerian people to benefit maximally. We are partnering with the same telcos we're talking about to make a difference in Nigeria. It's not just about sending money home. Like I said, nobody is sending money home anymore. People that are home, they're right here with us in Lagos, in Abuja, in Port Harcourt, making money. People now go to bring their grandmother, and of course, with all the security issues we have in Nigeria. And so I think our agency program is one of a kind. We partner with our agents to make money.
Okay, if I may cut you in there, how big is your agency strength in Nigeria to be able to cope with the 160 million populace who are being bombarded every day with mobile money campaign?
If I want to dwell more on that, as at the presentation, we'll do a lot more of that tomorrow.
All right.
But I can tell you that we have almost 10,000 agents. Less than a year of, we launched in September 2012. And this is June, we have over 10,000. That's outside the partnership we have with people that are embedded in the north. So when you're talking about just people that registered, agent registered on FirstBank mobile money platform, we have almost 10,000. And we have started partnership with organizations, and I won't be able to mention their name for confidentiality purposes. We have signed MOU with them. People who are established already in their thousands. When you look at it in total, we're over 20,000 agents, strong agents all over Nigeria. You can't beat that. Few mobile money players can beat that achievement in a short span of time. That's because of the tradition of what we have. And I don't forget that all 650 branches of FirstBank, they are agents. And each of those branches, they have 5 agents under them. Just to the little mat outside, so it's about 20 years apart. We are positioned to help Nigeria to get there. And we are going deep.
Okay, finally, what will you tell the guy, the young adult who is watching us on Tech 360NG, what will you tell them about FirstBank mobile money? Finally, in a few seconds.
Okay, FirstBank mobile money is a mobile money platform that has come to make a difference in your life in Nigeria by bringing financial services to your doorstep. You don't need to look for your grandmother's birth certificate or your grandmother's wedding certificate. All you need is just to have a phone, and then you're ready to do financial business. Join us. We're ready for you.
Excellent. Excellent.